for cross-country skiing, men's 10-kilometer individual, visually impaired.
We see Brian McKeever and his brother Brian, I'm sorry, his brother Robin in the red, waving to the crowd. One of Canada's finest athletes and one of the most dynamic pairs of skiers in the world, the McKeever team.
Mr. Rob Walsh, Chairperson, IPC Nordic Skiing Sports Technical Committee. Médaillé de bronze, représentant la Fédération de Russie. Bronze medalist, representing the Russian Federation, Nikolai Polukin with guide Andrei Tokarev.
Thank you very much.
Médaillé d'or et champion paralympique représentant le Canada.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing Canada. Brian McKeever with guide Robin McKeever.
Mesdames et messieurs, les médaillés paralympiques.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Paralympic medalists.
Congratulations to all of our Paralympians, and especially to these Paralympic medalists. Russian, Norwegian, and Canadian. So proud.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie de remise des fleurs du ski de fond femmes, épreuve individuelle, 5 km debout. Ladies and gentlemen, the flower ceremony for cross-country skiing, women's 5 km individual standing.
seront remises par Sir Philip Craven, président du Comité international paralympique.
The flowers will be presented by Sir Philip Craven, president of the International Paralympic Committee.
The one and only Sir Philip Craven, who we remember from the opening ceremonies and a huge influence here at these Paralympic Games.
Representant la Biélorussie. Bronze medalist representing Belarus, Larissa Verona. Representant l'Ukraine.
Silver medalist representing the Ukraine, Lilia Botenkova.
Médaillée d'or et championne paralympique représentant l'Ukraine.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing the Ukraine, Oleksandra Kononova.
Les médaillés paralympiques.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Paralympic medalists.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie de remise des fleurs du ski de fond femmes, épreuve individuelle, 5 km, déficience visuelle. Ladies and gentlemen, the flower ceremony for cross-country skiing, women's 5-kilometer individual, visually impaired. Par l'honorable Mary McNeil, ministre des Jeux Olympiques et Paralympiques.
The flowers will be presented by the honorable Mary McNeil, minister for the Olympic and Paralympic Games.
Médaillé de bronze, représentant la Fédération de Russie.
Bronze medalist, representing the Russian Federation, Tatiana Ilyuchenko with guide Valery Koshkin.
De Russie.
Silver medalist, representing the Russian Federation, Mikhailina Lizova, with guide Alexei Ivanov.
So exciting. You too. Everyone gets a kiss.
Médaillée d'or et championne paralympique représentant l'Allemagne.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion representing Germany, Verena Bentele with guide Thomas Friedrich.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Paralympic medalists.
So, two-thirds of the competition day already in the books. He's standing, indigenous merits here, and about four gold medals, four silvers, and four bronze. We have two of each color. Yet we've got 36 seconds in the event, women's 5K, men's 10K coming up at 12:20. We are inside 15 minutes to start. Actually, inside 15 minutes to start. So, y'all, grab a bite to eat. Be back here in just over 13 minutes for the continuation of day number 5 of cross country for Nordic Sport here at the Maryland Bank Park.
Thank you. And when you build it, you said you have a binding design that attaches to your system for your screen that is different than anyone else in the world. Can you explain a little bit about how you came about that?
The binding manufacturers store the CNC
Well, it's a beautiful day here at the Paralympic Park here in Whistler. Vancouver's weekend, Paralympic Winter Game, the action's getting underway in under 5 minutes now. The women's 5 kilometer 60 category, and this is going to be a very big competition between Olena Yurkovskaya, the gold medalist, and World Cup number one right now, against Colette Borgogna, who had a silver medal in this competition from Canada. She'll start last and she'll apologize on course. We also have four other Paralympic medalists in the start order. Three actually, because Svetlana Tikhonova, they did not start for the Ukraine, so that means Irina Komarenkova, So let's Fredonia as the past medalist in this competition.
Oui, exactement. Il y a une jolie pléiade de médaillés, comme tu viens de le dire, avec notamment la médaille d'or et archi grand favori de cette course, avec Lyudmila Vovchok, médaillée d'or sur la longue distance ici même, et médaillée d'argent sur cette courte distance qui va venir dans quelques instants, médaille d'argent des derniers jeux par Alain de Turin. On va retrouver aussi le médailleur Kovska, l'Ukraine avec le 144, Lyudmila Pavlenko avec le 146. Lyudmila Vovchok, nous en avons parlé avec le 147, et puis Colette Burgogne, la canadienne médaillée d'argent il y a quelques jours de là, c'était dimanche dernier, avec le 148, dernière à s'élancer dans cette catégorie.
So the competitors in the 60 category today, no kickbacks for these competitors, they just put them in the track and go anyway. So it's no classic or freestyle, it's just a 60 in the track. Maneuvering, we saw Chris Grable telling us how he works his 60. He will be starting with Div 76 at 12:33 in the United States. There you see what a beautiful crowd you all look like out there. And Steve, we've had a great turnout here today. Who are you with now, out in the stands?
Well, guys, it is an incredible energy here in the stands as we have about 500 school kids here in the house. Where's the crew from Buckingham Elementary? There they are. Where's the crew from Signal Hill Elementary? And who is the Classe Ecole de la Vallée Pierre-Bertrand? What's the move? Bienvenue, welcome all this to us, you guys!
There you see the snow conditions, hard pack, minus 6, snow temp, the coldest we've seen. Air temp is going up though, it's 2 Celsius. I can tell you kids that you're on international television. My mother-in-law lives in Finland. She was watching you guys yesterday live on Finnish television. So we know that at least in Finland everybody's seeing you. Here in the service.
Oui, exactement. Les conditions météo de la nuit, ça commence à se réchauffer. La neige est excellemment froide. Laisse savoir où est prise la température. Mais en tout cas, on voit 6 heures en moyenne sur la piste. La liste de départ avec la main qui envoie Andrea Esco avec le 132.3. Et on ira jusqu'à Colette Burgogne, la canadienne. 16 filles au départ. Vous voyez des listes de départ avec 8 italiennes, 4 ukrainiennes et 3 russes.
We are coming up on a minute to start now as we go through the list. We have Andrea Esco of Germany, won the bronze yesterday in biathlon, and that's her first Paralympic winner game. She will start the
And here we go with the women's 5K sitting. As number 133, Andrea Eskow, shoots out of the gate for Germany here at Whistler Paralympic Park. You're watching Paralympic Sport TV's coverage of the Vancouver 2010 Paralympic Winter Games. She will start out of the gate. And about a minute and a half after her will be the second competitor, Svetlana Trifonova from the Ukraine, a medalist here in these Paralympic Games. And next up will be number 135, Svetlana Yaroshevich of the Russian Federation. She'll be waiting for her moment. And she is out of the gate. you can see her pumping away there. Next up from Korea will be Varami Seo. And Seo pumping strong here. And of course, in these cross-country skiing, there is a classification percentage that will be used for an adjusted final time. And from the U.S., Monica Basicio. Basicio now on her way as the U.S. fans cheer her on. These chairs sit on modified skis. And Monica looking very strong here as she continues her movements. And we have from Denmark number 138, Nadia Stefurek. Stefurek being cheered on by her fans. Looks like we've got a little bit of a backtracking here. Oh, and a little bit of a crash. 138. Marianne Maibol going down. And 139 from the Ukraine, Nadia Stefurak is off and running. And number 140 from Norway will be Marianne Vestabostad. Vestabostad going strong. Had a little bit of a strange backtrack there. And one competitor to keep an eye on is Maria Ioleva. Ioleva, of course, no stranger to these Paralympic Games. And the Russian Federation support for her, very good. And Tatiana Tomashenko from the Ukraine. She's off. Tomashenko looking strong here. Coming out of the gate at 143 is Irina Polyakova. Polyakova. Irina looking strong. And next up, number 144, a woman to keep an eye on is Olena Ervaskovska. Ervaskovska, tremendous competitor here at these Paralympic Games. We'll see her moving her entire body as she propels herself with her arms. Many of our Paralympians so keenly aware of keeping consistent pace at the beginning of the race. And from Italy, number 145, Francesca Porcellato. Porcellato. Looks like she's getting a good start. And 146 from the Ukraine, Lyudmila Pavlenko. And she comes out of the gate strong. The sitting competition today, conditions are hard. You can see the snow packed down hard. And next up, number 147 from Belarus, Lyudmila Bochok. And she's pushing hard here. Bochok having plenty of cheers from the crowd. In our final in these women's 5K sitting competition, a woman to keep an eye on, Colette Burgonge. And plenty of love from the Canadian crowd. She is a past medalist here at these Paralympic Games. And we can expect a very strong performance for her. See Pavlenko coming around a corner. The Ukrainian pumping strong here, trying to catch the German after the half point mark. And we had that very interesting rollback. Here is Vochak from Belarus. She's looking very strong here and consistent. And you'll notice an undulating pattern in the arm to body motion as the positive technique will allow you to keep nice and smooth in your speed. And she is definitely one of the favorites here as she moves forward. Here we have number 148, Colette Burgonge, the local favorite. And 5 kilometers can go by so quickly. So the strategy could be to not be so conservative in the beginning, as in longer distances of 10 or 12.5 kilometers, they work their way up the hill. Burgonge making quick work of that uphill climb. And we see the beautiful crowd here gathering to support their Paralympians. And a seemingly warm day here at Whistler Paralympic Park. And Burgonge navigates her way around a bend. Gorgeous weather today, as you can tell. Ideal for so many events that we'll have here at Paralympic Sport TV. And we see the American, Monica Basio, looking to get her time in. And she'll be 35.9 seconds behind the current leader, German, represented by Eskow. And here we see Marianne Meibold. Marianne. She was the one that was affected by the backtrack. We'll see how much time she has there. It's 51.2 seconds behind the current leader. And here we have Yuleva, number 140, Marianne Vespodad. Vespertad doing her best and moves into second standing, pushing the American down to third.
There's the time of Vespertad. She moves ahead of Monica Bacio by 26 seconds.
Hey. And Ioleva looking very good here to get into second position and push down the other ladies, with the exception, of course, our current leader. Ioleva moves into second with 14.1 behind the current leader at the women's halfway mark. And we will also be starting the men's 10K sitting category in about 8 minutes. The women here making quick work of these hills. And Ioleva working well here. And we'll see a standings at 2.5 kilometers in the women's 5 kilometer sitting. Andrea Eskow currently in first. Maria Ioleva in second. And the Norwegian, Marianne Vespostad in third. Vespostad looking strong here as she works her way up. And you can hear the crowd cheering her on. She'll make a round left here. And we shall see the Korean competitor. Here we have Vora Misil. Current standings will be Andrea Eskow in the front, the Ukrainian Iriskovska in second, and Ioleva in third. Eskow holding on to her first position here at 2.5. And Pavlimko, number 146, looking strong here. And she will move into third position. And 145, Francesca Porcellato of Italy will be challenging Eskow for the first position. Porcellato pushing hard. We'll see if she's able to hit, and looks like she will. And she will take the first position by almost 9 seconds in her lead time. This lady here, Vochok, will have something to say about that. Trying to push Porcellato back, and she does, by just shy of 2 seconds. Vochok now currently in the lead. The Belarus Paralympian grabs the top spot at the halfway mark. And you can see how strong she is, digging her poles into the ground. And these ladies really giving it their all in this 5K competition. Vachok making steady work of this mountain. And here we have, it's Andrea Eskow working here from Germany. She'll be going into the final stretch. You can see after 2.5 kilometers, Vochok in the first position, Porcellato in the second. And here we have Bourgogne. She'll be looking to move into the first position if she can. And it looks like she'll be going to second. Oh, third. Third position from the local favorite. As Vochok holds on to the first position. Women continue to pound away here From 147, Ludmila Vochok going into the turn for the straightaway. And 147 Vochok going to make quick time of this mountain, I'm sure. Behind her, working hard, is Francesca Porcellato. And she looks like she's going to have to push on a little bit extra to make on this hill. And she'll cruise down here. And they will take their time. Vochok moving down as Porcellato also navigates her way down as well. And we'll take a look here at the standings. Vochok still in the lead. Porcellato in the second position. And Bourgogne from Canada sitting in third. As we've seen in the past, the Ukrainian and Russian showing has been so very strong here at these cross-country Paralympic Games. But Bourgogne has something to say about that. She'll continue to push forward. And if you'll notice in the top left corner, there's a calculated time. And the crossing there of a tremendous competitor, Colette Bourgogne, as she laps one of her competitors. And there we have, I believe that was McKeever, encouraging his fellow Canadian. And Bourgogne working so hard here. So competitive. Colette navigating a curve. And she looks like she's still going to be in third. And we'll see what the final lap will look like as we hear the bell. Wonderful to see Canadians supporting other Canadians. Take a look here, number 140, as Vespestad will be crossing the line. Second to Eskow at this point. But we'll see if her time will stand. And Vochok and Bourgogne will have something to say about that. And we saw Monica Basile going through, and Yuleva will move into second. And we've got quite a lot of competitors towards the end here that will be rivaling for the medals. And number 138, Marianne Meibel. And you see that familiar undulation movement to really maximize her speed and her technique. And Meibel will cross the line with fifth position. And she'll take a breather as she goes through. And here we see the Ukrainian Olena Yurskovska. Yurskovska looking so strong here, as we have seen before. She looks like she's poised to take the second position. And she will cross the finish line and go into second right now, just behind Esko by 8.3 seconds. And she'll take a second for a breather. Elena doesn't seem too happy with her time, but we'll see what happens here. And number 143 from Russia, Polyankova, looking to move into the fifth position as she pumps away for the end of her race. And it looks like she'll be able to knock down the American Bastio. And a strong hello from the Russian. She's going for shout outs for Russia. And we have other competitors coming into the finish line. 146, Pavlenko. Yudmila looking to get into third position here, which she will. And she will push Yuleva out of medal contention. But we have several other Paralympians on their way. And we'll see whether or not Pavlenko's time will hold. Pavlenko taking a moment to catch her breath. And here we see Vachok looking very strong. And looks like she'll be taking the first spot again, pushing all the other ladies down. As she pumps strong her arms, soaking in the crowd with a slight look over to her right. And she will cross the finish line and move into first with a 14.8 second top stop right now. And we will see whether her numbers will hold. We know that we have a Canadian hot on her trail with Bourgogne. And Vochok sending out some thank yous to everyone. And she looks so happy right now. My guess is that medal is so close. And here's Porcellato. Porcellato looking good here, pumping hard. She'll be trying to go for the third position. Can she do it? 5 seconds left to finish that cross. And it'll be close. And she'll move into at least fourth position, I think, maybe fifth. And she'll finish in fifth position thus far. So close. Porcellato from Italy working so hard. And that was a very, very good effort by the Italian Paralympian. She will be pushing several ladies back down as well. And it's just so close. And here we have the local favorite, Colette Bourgogne. And we shall see whether or not she's able to move into medal contention. And the local crowd cheering her on. It'll be rough get first. Let's see if she can hold on to second. She'll have just over 11 seconds left to go to cross that line to move herself into second place. The crowd cheering her on. 6 seconds, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and it looks like she'll be going into third if she can, putting her all into her last, and she'll move into third to try to get a medal here at these women's 5K sitting competitions. And a good effort there from the local favorite, Colette Bourgogne from Canada. And her fellow competitors coming to congratulate her. And after 5 kilometers, Ludmila Vochok still maintains first. In second, the German, Andrea Eskow, and third, Canadian favorite, Colette Bourgogne. And we have the men's competition coming up, already in the race. Here we have number 63, Vladimir Gasicka of Slovakia. And he is off. The men will do twice the distance as the women just now. They'll do the 10K. from Belarus, number 64, Yoheni Lukyanenka. Lukyanenka looking strong as he pushes forward. We have number 65, we've seen him before, from Poland, Robert Wader. Wader getting off to a good start. Next up, sporting number 66, is Bruno Uber. Uber looking very focused and determined out of the gate. You can see the commitment in his eye as he goes.
On peut plus, on peut pas monter plus haut, mais...
Get your Bruno, hop, 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 do it.
And Uber looking. Our next up, number 67, would be Alain Margouretaz. We'll have a good long list here of the men's 10K sitting competition. And number 68 next up will be from Norway, Per Fingerhoy. Fingerhoy looking good from the gate. He'll be pushing forward. You can hear the French words of encouragement as the U.S.'s Greg Malloroy is next. He'll come out of the gate pushing strong, and we'll see quick pull movements from Greg. As he cruises and navigates himself up. And from Italy, Roland Rupp. Rip. And he pushes hard out of the gate. You can see how strong he is giving each push. And the strokes are paying off here as he cruises down some. And I'm sure he'll be kicking up very soon. There he is. And from China, Chunshan Fu is next up. The Chinese traditionally not too big on these Winter Paralympic Games, but that's changing as we see greater numbers of Chinese Paralympic athletes coming in. Number 72, Vladimir Kiselev is next. And Kiselev looking strong. A beautiful day here at Whistler Paralympic Park. So clear and sunny. A great way to continue our coverage. And here is bronze medalist Andy Sewell from the U.S. going for another medal in his trophy case. Very good there. After Andy will be Eric Zaripov from Russia. He's definitely no stranger to these Paralympic games. And Zaripov, a local favorite. Keep a close eye on this competitor as he shows what he's made of. Next up will be number 75 from Poland, Kamil Rosiak. Number 176, Chris Klibel from the U.S. He'll come out of the gate strong. And Klibel getting some support and love from the crowd. Next up, number 77 from Belarus, Dmitry Lobin. Lobin looking very strong here as he pushes. And we've noticed that technique plays such a crucial role in the success of our Paralympians. Here's number 78 in the U.S., Sean Halstead. And he's got that look of focus in his eye. Number 79 from Norway. Definitely a man to keep your eye on. Trygve Toskedal Larsen. And nearing the end of our men's 10K sitting classification opening. You see Larsen there in a speed position. Five more competitors yet to come out of the gate in these men's 10K competition. This is definitely a man to keep your eye on. The Ukrainian Yuri Kostyuk is number 80. He is definitely no stranger to winning medals. And he will cruise here for a little bit. And number 81, Enzo Maceo from Italy, comes out of the gate here as well. We saw him, I think, win a medal a little while ago. Enzo, determined to go for another medal. 82, Romain Rosic from France is next. And he is out of the gate. As the French fans chant, go, 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 in French. Number 83 is up next, from the Russian Federation, Roman Peshkov. Peshkov, definitely one of the major contenders here at these cross-country skiing competitions. You probably noticed that many of our cross-country skiers will also be competing in the biathlon. And our final of our men's 10K sitting competition competitors will be from Belarus, Alexander David Davidovich. Davidovich pushing hard here as he goes. Davidovich, excuse me. And after 4 minutes and 11 seconds, Klebel is looking to catch the Russian Zarapov. And Klebel will be in 10th position, Zarapov in first. Lerner now in third at the 4.9 kilometer, almost halfway mark. And we'll see our Paralympians working hard here. Two different styles on your left and your right on how to tackle the hill. I believe that's our Italian competitor. And coming up, number 78, Sean Halstead moves into fifth position. As you see, number 79 here, Larson, getting as much momentum before he gets to the hill. And he will push himself forward, using the technique of staying off of the traditional trail, and that will allow him just a smidget off of first at 0.2 seconds off the lead. Looks like we're up for a fight here between first and second. And here we see Shilov doing his best to catch the current leader at the 4.9. As we've noticed before, the competition between the Russians and the Ukrainians, so very intense, with a sprinkle of German and Belarus competitors in there. Sometimes as a surprise, as we saw in the men's category. In the standing, it was Nita from Japan taking it. And looks like we've got a new current leader, it's Zarapov from Russia. And Kostiuk moving into fourth from the Ukraine, number 80. Tremendous upper body strength you can see there. And you see number 61 right behind him from France, Batega. I believe this is one of our Italian competitors, number 81, Enzo Maciejo. Maciejo working hard. And Rosic looking to move into the third or possibly fourth position. And right behind him, you can see number 63, Vladimir Gachukskar, moving into fourth. And number 83, Roman Risk. And here's Zarapov up to challenge the current leader, Kiselev. Zarapov pumping strong, and he will take the lead by over 22 seconds from Kiselev. Tremendous competitor that he is. And we'll see who can maintain their pace. And after 1.6 kilometers, we see Eric Zarapov in the first position. The Norwegian Larsen in second by just 0.2 seconds, and Roman Petchikov, the Russian, sitting in third.
Charges from behind, because right now Zarapov is leading early in the race, but will some people come and challenge him late in the running order? It's 10 kilometers, long way to go yet.
At 1.6 kilometers, there's a lot of race to go, and we shall see whether or not our other competitors will have a chance at coming at our current leader. And there he is. Zarapov pumping strong. And the there's plenty of race left here. And behind him, you can see number 73, Andy Sewell, the American working his best. And Zaripov making quick work of that uphill battle. And we will be cruising here in a second. Trying to maximize his speed as best he can. Zaripov looking very good as he navigates his turns. And number 79, the Norwegian Larsen. Looking very good here. And the men have now completed the top five of one third of this race. But I'm certain we'll have the Olympians who started later challenging those times. Zaripov still maintaining his lead. Kiselev in second, but moves down to third, thanks to Larsen, the Norwegian. See Larsen, committed and enduring. He pushes himself to the max for the race. And Larsen continues to go down the hill. It's a beautiful day six of these Paralympic Games. And here we see number 80, Louis Kostyuk. He'll continue to press on. Kostyuk in contention for second now at the one-third mark of these 10K. Moving into fourth position, pushing back the Belarus competitor Loban. And you can hear the encouragements from the French supporters. Can see those muscles in number 80, Kostyuk bulging as he moves his way up the hill. These cross-country skiing competitions, so important to maintain your consistency as you move your way up. At 10 kilometers, it is a very long race. So how you expel your energy has to be one of the most important ways to keep yourself competitive. As we look at the top 10 in the current standings at 3.3 kilometers. We're going to see quite a lot of energy exerted as Loban makes a round and tries to move into second place. Loban, about 10 seconds left to see at the midway mark whether the Paralympian from Belarus will be able to push back the Russian Kiselev, and he does by just shy of 0.2 seconds. The current standings between silver and bronze. And at this point, fatigue has to be settling in for some of those Paralympians. Our cross-country skiers. Here we see Zarapov in the lead, and right behind him is Norway's Larsen. Zarapov looking good at the midway mark. Larsen trying to move into second position by pushing back Loban. Larsen pumping strong. And he indeed moves into second position, just shy of 5 seconds from Loban. And we'll probably look here at the standings after 3.3 kilometers. Eric Zarapov in the lead as the Norwegian Larsen is in second, and Peshchikov, the Russian, in third. To round out your top three, hot on their trails is Vladimir Kiselev in fourth, as we see here. Eric Zarapov currently in first position. This ice is quite hard right now on the track. Trying to minimize as much friction as you go as possible.
The story at 3.3 kilometers was Eric Zarapov leading by 11.
And you can hear the words of encouragement. Zarapov still in the lead, but Cheshikov from Russia trying to move into the second position to push Larsen back. And we've seen so many times these cross-country skiing competitions of battle between Russia and the Ukraine, Norway and Germany. Peshchikov pushing hard. Yes, he is now currently in second. 2.5 seconds from third. So it looks like we'll continue to have a fight between second and third spots here. That was Roland Rupp, number 70, from Italy, as he makes his way. And we'll take a look here at the standings after 4.9 kilometers. In first place, Eric Zarapov continues his lead. Roman Peshchikov in second, his fellow Russian. And in third place right now, Larsen from Norway, looking good in third. And Zarapov moving further in first place. So it looks like we'll have a fight between second and third if Zarapov continues to hold steady in his lead. And there we see number 71, then 72, Kiselev. Kiselev working hard as well. The Russian contingent looking very good here in first and second in these cross-country skiing competitions.
That is Vladimir Kiselev, you see leaving the stadium. Right behind him, though, is number 74, the leader.
And here's Zarapov, number 74.
On his teammate, Kiselev.
Continuing to push forward. And Zarapov coming on Chunchenshan of China as they continue their movement here. Looks like Zarapov may be lapping some of his competitors. and you can see the warm air coming off of bouncing off of this shiny ice.
Vladimir Kizilev est deuxième, Dmitry Loban, le Biélorusse, il est troisième à l'heure, à l'instant même. Eh bien, c'est fait doubler par Kizilev. Et ouais, Vladimir Kizilev qui fait une grosse fin de course. Vladimir Kizilev qui fait une très très grosse fin de course de Russe. On pourrait peut-être même avoir trois Russes avec Zapiro,
Petushkov
et Kizilev. Peut-être un triplé russe.
Number 78.
Attention, justement, l'arrivée.
Sean Halstead. From the U.S. moving forward there, but right behind him, number 79, is Larson, looking to pass as well. Larson making some good work over Kiselev, and a very good chance that Larson will overtake Kiselev into the second position at the 6.6 kilometer mark. Larson seemingly consistent in maintaining his energy, and we'll see whether Larson's able to move into second here. And we hear the bell. Larson indeed moves into second place, tied with Kiselev. And Larson crouches down here. You may see Larson passing number 78, the American Sean Halstead. Halstead doing his steady work. And number 74, there we see our current leader, Eric Zaripov. So strong here, and if he's able to maintain and not have any real problems, he may be tasting Paralympic gold. You may notice that the getup from France seems to be in first here, but Zaripov knows that he'll be overtaking him very soon, by over a minute and a half, as Zaripov takes him out. Chen Shanfu in second, but that'll be short-lived, as our current second and third standing competitors will be moving over Fu. And Zaripov looking very good, extending his lead out. His fellow compatriot Vladimir Kiselev in second, and Norwegian Wonder Larson moves into third, ties for second as well, as we have currently tied for second. Roman Petrikov looking strong here to see if he can move into second place. And as you can see there, looks like we have the Russian Petrikov moving into fourth, pushing down number 77 from Belarus, Dmitry Loben. And just such a gorgeous day to enjoy these cross-country skiing competitions. Petrikov looking good as he begins to take the hill. Maybe these guys are so warmed up now that all it is just maintaining that intensity. I think we'll see a real fight here for second and third place. Zaripov seems to be pulling away from the pack in great power. Kiselev looking good as well. And here we have number 77, Dmitry Loben, striving for the second position over Kiselev. Belarus and Russia seems to be fighting it out for second and third. Loban looking good here as he goes down to maintain his speed. plenty of words of encouragement. You see number 79 there, Larson, right behind the American, number 78, Sean Halstead. And we may be seeing Larson overtaking Halstead very soon. Seems to be drafting him as they go. Tri-Gabe Toscadel Larson trying to move.
Get out! Get out!
Trying to, seems like Larson is trying to pass the American. Halstead seems to be in his way. And the two continue to push forward. Larson seems to now have moved into fourth position, as Sean Halstead is in fifth. And we'll see what their following times will be. Zaripov still continues to be in first. Dmitry Loban from Belarus still in second. And Vladimir Kiselev in third. We see Larson and Halstead are pushing each other here.
And
they are going at each other. Now, Sean Halstead is a 98 percentile here. Larson is a 100 percentile. So those numbers will be calculated into their final adjusted score for their final time. And that may be a determining factor, that 2% that I believe Halstead has on Larson. As we know, the Norwegian perfectly capable of coming in very competitive in medal contentions here. And we will look here at our competitors coming in through the finish line. Baguetta already in first, but he'll be pushed back by the Russian Zaripov by a commanding lead of 1 minute and 53 seconds. And Zaripov, there you see the man there, the lead and the powerhouse from Russia, Eric Zaripov, as number 83, Romain Petrikov, working hard to move up. Petrikov cruising down there. And Zaripov's got to feel good about his time. Doesn't look like he's breathing too heavily, making good work of these 10Ks. And I'm sure he'll be throwing up some love for his country. And here's number 81, Enzo Macio, at the 8.2 kilometer mark. Zaripov just so fast and commanding here in the men's 10K sitting competition. And a beautiful shot of Whistler Mountain, some of the snow up on the top. We'll probably take a look at the current standings here. Zaripov still in first place, with Vladimir Kiselev, his compatriot, in second. And currently in third is Trinshan Fu. But you'll remember that our competitors started a lot earlier, and we shall see where our other competitors that start off later will finish. There will be definitely a fight between second and third here, and our Paralympians will be fighting over that. But Eric Zaripov showing his dominance. And here we see number 77 from Belarus, Dmitry Loban. Loban giving it his all in the straightaway. And he will be looking for second place to push back Kiselev. Loban looking very good for it, giving good speed for himself, maintaining that as he moves in to Paralympic history. And he will currently be standing in second, as right behind him is Greg Mallory from the U.S. crossing over the finish line. But there is Dmitry Loban from Belarus currently now in second. And he'll take a moment to collect his breathing. And we shall see, there's apparently a fight between Sean Halstead and Larson for who can pass who. Hopefully we'll move over there and see some coverage of that. And so far, Zaripov in first, Dmitry Loban in second, and in third from Russia, Vladimir Kiselev in third. Here's 75, Kamil Rosiak. 75 moving across. Rosiak will finish in 15th for the current standing. And here we have Sean Halstead. And he will move into fourth position as we see number 79 from Norway, Larsen, taking fifth just now. And respectable finishes. The two Americans coming over to talk to each other. Sean Halstead and his allowance to come over and congratulate his other fellow Paralympians. That was number 73, Andy Sol. And here is the Russian Petshchikov. Peshukov looking good as he moves his way down. Tremendous upper body strength our Paralympians have.
We're going to find out in a matter of moments. Il y a un match entre Petushkov, Loban et Massino maintenant.
And we shall see very soon whether Roman Petshchikov, currently in third position at the 8.2 kilometer mark, will be able to medal here. He rounds out this left and he will go through the straightaway. And if he pushes hard here, there's a very good chance he'll be able to take second. Petshchikov really giving his all now as he goes for the silver. He's got 5 seconds to finish there. We'll see if he's able to do it. Looking strong here, and it looks like he'll finish in third position. Yes, and he does. Petshchikov now looking good for the bronze. Looking very, very good for the bronze. Petshchikov, what a tremendous effort there towards the end to push himself into medal contention. And here we see number 81, Enzo Massio from Italy. His time looks good too. He may be pushing Petshchikov off. Looks very good for that. Enzo pushing strong to the cheers of the Italian fans. Massio giving his all. And he's looking very good to go into second. And I think he will. Yes, he does. Massio goes into second. And he must be ecstatic here. He's won medals in the past. And it looks like he may be winning another medal here to the enthusiasm of the Italian fans. Enzo Massio for Italy raises the flag here, but we have Lyrik Kostyuk from the Ukraine going to answer back here, and Kusik looking to push Loban out. We'll see if he can go into third. Oh, and Kostyuk goes from fourth, the Ukrainian just short of a medal. So close. What a competitor. Such strength, but just short. And he's got to be a little disappointed. But here we have the current standing. Eric Zaripov in first. The Italian Enzo Massio in second. And from Belarus, Dmitry Loban in third. At the men's 10K sitting category of this cross-country skiing. We shall see whether those numbers will stand. Lots of men's competitors here at these men's 10K sitting competition. And here is Eric Zaripov, definitely taking first position with a tremendous performance in these men's 10K sitting competitions. And here's number 82, Romain Rusc from France. He'll be looking to finish. Rusc pumping hard here. French fans cheering him on. And Rusc giving a strong effort towards the end. Looks like he'll be finishing in number 18 by edging out number 19 by just 0.2 seconds. And almost running into our Italian second place stander, Enzo Massillo. And as a result here, looks like Zaripov will take first, Enzo Massillo will take second, and Dmitry Loban from Belarus will take third. As we take a look at the remaining finishers, hope you're enjoying Paralympic Sport TV's coverage of the Vancouver 2010 Paralympic Winter Games. Such a pleasure to be with you as we go through these celebrations of ability in world-class sports. And I think we've got those as your final positions. And Zaripov looking so strong with the gold. And Halstead so close to medaling, but a great effort from the young American. You're watching Paralympic Sport TV's coverage of the Vancouver 2010 Paralympic Winter Games. We appreciate your support.